Good evening, RMS Queen Mary. May I say how proud you look sitting over there in Long Beach Harbor? This is Commodore Everett, and I would like to say a hearty hello to all of my beloved shipmates and all of our guests that have taken their time to come down tonight and enjoy this delicious event. And we hope that you will all enjoy yourself. We have a spectacular show in store for you, and we would like to send you a special little greeting. But before we do that, I would like to say I send my compliments as well as Clark from the Cunard.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome aboard the Queen Mary. On behalf of the Queen Mary, the City of Long Beach, and Evolution Hospitality, we all want to welcome you aboard. Isn't this a wonderful evening? Let's hear it for our wonderful Queen Mary, shall we? All of you tonight are going to be part of a wonderful historical event, much like many passengers that have traveled the wonderful Cunard ships, the Queen Mary and the Queen Elizabeth. Tonight you're going to be a part of history as you watch the two ships meet for the first time since their namesakes met, the Queen Mary, of course the original, and the Queen Elizabeth on September 25th, 1967. You are a part of history, just like so many wonderful historic events that the ships witnessed over their wonderful years. So let's hear it for the Queen Elizabeth. Let's hear it for the Queen Mary. We welcome you. Please enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
Indeed, the Queen Mary looks beautiful tonight. She is so lovely with all her lights flashing and all the camera lights flashing as the Queen Elizabeth approaches that gracious stern. You all have a marvelous sight tonight, and we have a marvelous sight as well. And I just have to tell everyone on board, at this point, I'm a slightly jealous because three funnels make a beautiful crown.
The horn.
largest and fastest ships on the Earth, but the smallest and slowest ships that could do the job at hand. Their dimensions were staggering, each being over 1,000 feet in length, a gross tonnage of over 80,000 tons, and with 30 knot speed capability. The Queen Mary would come first, making her maiden voyage in May of 1936. She would be the ship of choice with passengers, and therefore one of the most profitable liners of the pre-war era. She would also become the fastest ship on the North Atlantic, vying with the French liner Normandy for speed supremacy and the Blue Ribbon of the Atlantic. The Queens were built for the arts of peace, to act as a mighty loom, weaving a tapestry of goodwill and understanding between the old and new worlds. However, in the grand scheme of things, their biggest contribution and gift to mankind was to deliver 1.5 million military personnel around the globe in the Second World War to defend the freedom we cherish today. Winston Churchill said, "The Queens, Mary and Elizabeth, challenged the theories of Hitlerism, and without their contribution, final victory would have been postponed indefinitely." After the war, from 1947 to 1967, the glorious sisters, Queen Mary and Queen Elizabeth, crisscrossed the North Atlantic on their appointed schedule, many times sighting one another in mid-ocean. This wonderful oceanic interlude was relished by passengers, captains, and crew alike, for there was no finer sight than to witness the largest and most beautiful ships of that era in their natural element, splashing the sea aside with a great bone in their teeth like thoroughbred greyhounds. In the glory days, the Queens were the golden standard of ocean travel, literally paying for themselves every year. The last time the two sisters met was September 25th, 1967. In the small hours of the morning, the Queen Mary, eastbound and charging along at better than 28 knots, was on her final transatlantic voyage in the Cunard service. In the cool, starlit autumn darkness, Commodore Geoffrey Marr stood at attention on his flying bridge of the surging westbound Queen Elizabeth. Captain Treasure Jones was in the same position on the Mary. As the two great queens quickly closed on each other, the lights were flashed on, scattering the indigo Atlantic night in Cunard red. Porthole pearls were in regal red. Each captain doffed his hat as the mighty Typhon whistle pierced the ether in a fantastic farewell salute.
Unabated today. This brings to mind the prophecy spoken
by a well-known English psychic, Lady Mabel Fortescue Harrison, on the day of her launch in 1934, when she said, "The Queen Mary will know her greatest fame and popularity when she never sails another mile or carries another fare-paying passenger." This has proven true, as the Queen Mary has been visited by countless millions since embarking upon her present role. As a hotel and place for special events, the Queen Mary features much of her original decor. Known as the Ship of Beautiful Woods, her interiors are bathed in 56 different species of exotic wood veneers sewn from all over the British Empire. There are three award-winning restaurants: the Observation Bar, which served as the inspiration for the Commodore's Club and today's Cunard fleet; a tea room; and 346 first-class staterooms, including posh suites named after the famous travelers that once occupied them. Possessing an almost tangible magic, the Queen Mary is said to be more than any other, a ship with a soul. Further underscoring the precious bond between master and mistress, Captain Jones would say of his beloved ship, "She has character. She has personality. She even breathes. But above all else, she is the closest thing to a living being that I have ever commanded." Here we are, nearly 77 years after the Queen Mary's maiden voyage, and 45 years since Captain Jones sailed her triumphantly into Long Beach. We stand aboard Queen Elizabeth, the youngest Cunarder in the modern fleet, so elegantly appointed, with every creature comfort imaginable, and so comfortable to travel in. I can say this firsthand, as I have had the privilege to sail in the Queens of today. Cunard's renaissance is nothing short of remarkable. At the end of the Queen Mary's sea life, it was thought that the day of the big passenger ship was forever over. It seems in some ways history does repeat itself. It certainly has for Cunard, who are again at the forefront of ocean travel. Cunard has one of the youngest fleets at sea, the magnificent flagship Queen Mary II, the stunning Queen Victoria, and this lovely new Queen Elizabeth. These splendid new queens capture the very essence and character of a bygone era, with all the classic decor, pleasing textures, and classic Cunard White Star service. Tonight belongs to the Queen Mary and the Queen Elizabeth, the most sanguine names in the history of mankind and the sea, both old and new. Long may they reign as the supreme expression of ocean travel. To you, Queen Mary, the stately ship, now in being, we salute you as you so proudly breast the ebb and flow. Always have following winds to help your ships along. I say this